I'm here today with Emma Straub to talk about her new book, Laura Lamont's Life in Pictures. Emma, thank you for joining us today.
Thank you for having me.
So it's been a busy year for you so far, 2012. You wrote a collection of stories that came out in February, Other People We Married, and now you are here with a new novel. So you have been working hard.
And I wish I could say that that is all I've done. Unfortunately, I also went on tour with a band and have done a lot of other things. I have several other jobs too, so.
Yeah, I wanted to ask you about that because I was reading your blog, which I really love, mm-hmm. and I know that you've been touring with the Magnetic Fields, which is one of my favorite bands ever, and I'm so jealous of your life for that reason and others. But I wanted to talk to you about how all these different things that you do, that you work as a designer, you've been a bookseller, you're writing two books a year, touring with a great band. How does all that find its way into your books? What is your sense of the artistry of the book when you have all these influences sort of behind you?
Well, I think the key for me so far has been time management and making sure that I can really focus on one thing at a time. So when I was writing the stories for the collection, that's all I was doing. It's all I was writing. That's not true either. I also write for a teenage girl website called Rookie, and I do that while I'm doing everything else also. But I try as much as possible to designate chunks of time every day to focus on, whether it's writing the stories or writing the novel or designing things with my husband, or certainly when I'm working at the bookstore, I'm not also writing fiction. So it's really just about making schedules for myself and sticking to them as much as I can.
And do you find that your experiences and those other roles that you have come into play when you're thinking about your characters and the worlds that you're trying to build?
Probably. I mean, certainly with Laura Lamont's Life in Pictures, which is a book that takes place mostly in Hollywood, but there are some sections in Door County, Wisconsin, the traveling that I've done has definitely informed that, and I had been to Los Angeles, many, many, many times. But I'd been with the band, and I'd been on my book tour for the story collection. Sometimes all my jobs sort of dovetail together nicely, and I can do everything at once. Whenever I travel anywhere, it's always secretly a research trip. Mm-hmm. When I go on vacation, I take notes. And
right. A consummate observer.
I try.
So where was Laura Lamont born? I mean, she is born in the book. She's not born Laura, but where was she born for you? Where did the idea for her come from?
She was born for me a couple of years ago. I was reading the obituaries in the New York Times, which is always the best section of any newspaper. And I read the obituary for an actress named Jennifer Jones, and it was heartbreaking. I mean, I suppose, many obituaries are. She had lived a really long life, but it was the richness of her life that really struck me. She had been married several times and had all these children, and her career had really dramatic highs and lows. And I read it, and it was probably 800 words or something like that, but I said, that is a novel. It was so clear to me that it was a novel and that it was my novel. So I copied it down and I put it in my notebook and I left it alone for a little while, and I found that I kept coming back to it. And I wanted to stay away from Jennifer Jones's actual biography and her films. I didn't watch any of her films, but I started watching a lot of other old movies and reading about the studio system, the Hollywood studio system, and that's how it got started.
And she's a remarkable character, I think, for an actress, for a character who's an actress, because she's so self-possessed and she has such little drama to her. She has that sort of Midwestern stock, right? And that's where she's, where we first meet her. But so much is happens to her and in her life and around her, then she just it's this kind of rock, and she absorbs it all. She's such an interesting woman.
Yeah.
So does she have any like literary antecedents, or are there other heroines you love that found their way into her DNA?
Oh, that's a good question. It actually, when I was thinking about her and the arc of her life, I wasn't actually thinking about a heroine, but I spent a lot of time thinking about Martin Dressler, who is the titular character in that novel of Stephen Milhauser's. He's one of my favorites, and Martin Dressler is an astonishing book. And it takes, like Laura Lamont, it takes a character from childhood through his entire life. And it goes really wild, weird places. But the character himself is very steady and sort of unshakable, which is what I wanted her to be. Like, I wanted her to be a strong female character. Like, even though bad things happen to her and she certainly does not always behave perfectly, I wanted her to be steady. I mean, you said like Midwestern stock, and she is. She's from Wisconsin. She's, she comes from a really strong family, and that's what I wanted. And also another book that I was thinking about when I was writing is John Williams Stoner, which is another. I don't want to say bleak portrait of a person's life, but it's pretty dark.
Yeah.
And there's a lot of unhappiness, but it's also a really beautiful book, and I wanted to try to do that also, to present her life, all the different facets of her life, in a way that made you appreciate the dark periods as well as the happy ones.
I like the way that you explore that world too, of that period in cinema and Los Angeles, and it was just, it's a time that has a lot of romance, I think, to us now.
Yeah.
But it's a really tough business and hard on people, and a lot of cruelty happening. And like, you're not afraid to go there and like look behind the curtain of like how that studio system operated. And I find it really fascinating. And I've just it's something I've been just interested in lately, and I don't know, thinking about like Frances Farmer and like her whole story, that's a really rich place to explore, like this relationship that develops between Laura and Irving. But did you do a lot of research on that? Did you watch a lot of films?
Did
you read about all the the big producers?
I highly recommend, just for anyone, if you want to write a book that requires research, make the research old movies, because it makes everything just so much fun. You're like, oh, what's playing at the Film Forum? Oh, it's a double feature, Fred Astaire and Ginger Rogers. I have to go. I can't stay home and work. I have to go watch them dance. I did a lot of that sort of research, but I also spent a lot of time at the library, because I wanted to really understand the studio system, because I didn't feel like I wanted to write about it with authority and not be worried that, real Hollywood historians would come knocking on my door and being like, you got that completely wrong.
Right.
How dare you? So I spend a lot of time actually at a library in Los Angeles called the Margaret Herrick Library, that's owned and operated by the Academy of Motion Pictures, and they have everything. They have, it's all they have. I mean, it's a dedicated library to the history of Hollywood. Mm. And they have books about, so I would read, Irving Thalberg's biography and Hedy Lamarr's memoir, The Ecstasy and Me. I read everything back to back to back to back to back, which was really a delicious way to spend a lot of time.
And I think the feeling, that cinematic feeling comes into your prose very clearly. I mean, there's such an aesthetic feel to Elsa / Laura from the very beginning, and she's a very sensory creature. So seeing that whole world through her eyes is, it's beautiful, it's really arresting, and it has its own, I feel like her vision of the way things are and ought to be just becomes, has a life of its own in the story, so I appreciated that a lot.
Thank
you for that. But I wonder, I'm circling back to a question we've talked about in the beginning, which was, you have this you have such an interesting mix of skills and sort of work that you do. And I wonder if you think about when you're writing that that your sort of visual sense of, you know, parts of your life really come in to your words very strongly. So
yeah, I think so. I mean, the visual world has always been very important to me, and I do try to make that a part of the book. And with this book in particular, I thought it was really important, because when you're talking about the movies, people have such a firm understanding of what that looks like already, you mm-hmm. know, whether it's these lights or the camera. You know, people know what those things look like, and they can sort of picture a movie set. And so I wanted to really try to bring as much of that, those sort of visual cues in as possible. And I, you know, I went and I did all these tours of studios in Hollywood, and I mean, I'm a really like a fan at heart and an enthusiast. And that was, I mean, I loved it so much, like riding around on a little golf cart around Paramount Studios and like just taking notes. It was me and like all of these Italian tourists. And I don't know what they were. I mean, they were really excited when the cast of Glee walked by, but I was really excited like just by seeing like all these old buildings that had been there forever, and these old parts of sets, and mm-hmm. Yeah, I mean, there were all these things that I saw that I just, when I saw them and I realized that what I was seeing, like there was a parking lot, for example, that was painted blue, and it was because it's where they film ocean scenes. When they need them, they move all the cars, they fill it with water, and voila, they can make waves and you've got an ocean. So I was like conscious of, you know, looking at that gigantic blue parking lot, not very exciting, but also the fact that I was seeing like the possibility of what could be there.
Right.
So yeah, I mean, there were lots of layers of observation at work.
I think too, when you're writing about movies, it would be challenging, because there's like a show don't tell sort of, right. you know, principle really yeah. at work there, because yeah. trying to capture that viewer experience and being, you know, caught up in a film is very different than writing about being caught yeah. up in a film, right?
Yeah.
And knowing your medium and being able to toggle back and forth.
Yeah.
I like how this book does that.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for being here today.
My pleasure.
It was great to meet you.
Thank you for having me.